Hi, everybody. Sorry I've not been around this week so much. I ended up in accident and emergency again last week in the hospital. Since my accident, I have, when my immune system crashed and I put on all that weight and lots of weight, I have a problem now if I get bitten, if I cut myself, anything that happens. I end up getting an infection, my antibodies overreact, and I end up having to take loads of antihistamine and antibiotics, antihistamine, fluids, you name it, I have to do it. Anyway, today is a day where I'm editing at home. I'm finishing off the Lindsay Dracuss promotional video and finishing off her portion of her slot on Should Have Been a Star. One thing that Britain's Got Talent has shown us all this year is that if you come back, feel good factor, lots of talent, lots of diversity, the public love it. They've wiped out the ratings for The Voice. I have to say The Voice doesn't work for me at all. I can only say that seeing those famous people jumping around on and off the seats, trying to pretend that they're cool and with it and whatever, doesn't work. Having listened to one or two of them think that they are qualified to be coaches as well as pop stars and performers worries me. Learning about coaching and teaching requires that you understand the technology of the voice, the muscles. I'm sure you know, people like Jessie J have been coached at Performing Arts College. She's got an amazing voice. However, whether you can teach other people and take the risk of damaging their voices, I'm not sure. A lot of those people on The Voice have already got great voices. So, you know, it's not rocket science, is it? There's not much to tweak, really. It's just a question of exposure. And I come back to this again and again and again. Exposure is what makes a star. Regular exposure, regular fan base, regularly in the news. That's what makes you famous, that's what makes you successful, and that's what gives you power over your career. And there's no getting over the fact that, like it or not, there are people out there who should be stars who aren't getting exposure. And one of the things I'm on a learning curve about is with filming and directing that Should Have Been a Star is some people, when they see you coming from a different area, doubt your ability to be able to do your job. They doubt your credibility to do something. Stand firm, believe in yourself, and don't stop. Keep pushing forward, keep pushing forward. If you think you've got something special, then believe in it. And if somebody else doesn't believe in it, then you have to leave them behind. Because something I have learned recently is when your instinct on a job or out there on the stage or in a performance or even technically is telling you to do something and somebody is preventing you from doing that, you're best walking away rather than arguing and fighting a losing battle. I've just been doing some editing recently, and the editing itself just proves to me that on a shoot I should have stood firm and stuck to my guns, and I didn't. And so I'm having all hell's bells to edit at the moment with some stuff that I'm doing, and I've learned a lesson there. It's all good, really. I'm well now and I'm better. Performance-wise, I had a great weekend. And, you know, you are all out there rooting for me. You know, you're all out there willing me to do well. And that's brilliant. I am so chuffed with the fan base that I've got and all the friends I'm making, and some of you out there are just amazing musicians and performers, and I thank you for trusting me and coming on board with me at the moment. And I'll be back soon. Good luck to the winner of Britain's Got Talent and the dog. I don't care what you say, variety talent, we need it, whether it's a dog or human being. we need the variety. Variety is dying. And it's okay having all the Madonnas and the Kylies and all the samey stuff, and they're all great, and all the warbly voices like Mariah and Jessie and fabulous. But, you know, eventually you can have so many of those before they all sound the same. It's like filming, you know, you have to make each individual person have a kind of like identity of their own. Otherwise it all looks samey, and, you know, you don't want it looking samey, you want it looking unique. You need to be unique, and that's what makes you as well a star. Exposure, a fan base, and being yourself uniquely in your talent and having belief in yourself, never giving up. Okay, back to the grindstone. See you soon.